God may be trying to pull someone out of your life, and you are still bent on hanging on to them. When you hang on to people that are not meant to be in your life, God cannot bring you the right ones because you are so busy hanging on to the wrong ones. You need to understand that everything happens for a reason. One thing I've learned to accept is that people come and people go. The friends you may have made in the past may no longer be around today. Also, the people you expected to stick around may have left you, and you ask God why. Let me tell you this, nothing just happens. God doesn't just allow things to happen. He is a God of purpose. He doesn't make mistakes. Everything that happens in this world happens at the time God chooses, and it is for a reason. Nothing just happens. We can trust in God's plan because He knows what He is doing. He is not a God of happenstance. He is proposed, prepared, and planned. He knew you before you were formed in your mother's womb. He sanctified you and ordained you. This clearly shows that everything happens for a reason. That job may seem right. That relationship may seem perfect to you. That contract may look genuine. That business may be blossoming. That man or woman in your life may seem the best, but the end thereof might be disaster. Only God knows the end. You need to admit that God sent them out of your life in order to fulfill His divine plan for your life. God's ultimate plan is that we live forever in His kingdom. When we give our lives to God, we are giving Him permission to do His will in our lives. Not everyone in your life has the capacity to accommodate the greatness God has deposited inside of you. So let me ask you this. Is your life surrounded by dream killers or destiny builders? Think about it very well. God knows who will discourage and resist His great plan for your life. God knows who will be of bad influence and knows what trouble this might bring. So God in His wisdom removes someone that you might not even realize is dragging you down maybe into sinful practices. If you knew something was wrong with your car, you'd probably take it into a mechanic and have them look it over. So God sometimes looks over our situation and knows that we are sometimes better off without someone. God simply removes them from our lives. Therefore, anything or anyone that comes in the way of fulfilling God's plan in your life, He will remove. God sent them out of your life because they may be toxic. There are many toxic people in this world. You may encounter some of these people every day and not even know it. They may secretly hate you or become more and more toxic as time goes by. We can only see what people allow us to see, but God sees the heart. He sees all of the secret thoughts and conversations that others may have about you. God knows exactly how much you can bear. Therefore, He may remove someone from your life in order to protect you. God sent them out of your life because they may be needed somewhere else. Moses went and returned to Jethro, his father-in-law, and said unto him, "Let me go, I pray thee, and return unto my brethren which are in Egypt, and see whether they be yet alive." And Jethro said to Moses, "Go in peace. God has a plan for everyone's life, including that person. God's plan might take them away from you when their season in your life is over." God sent them out of your life because he or she isn't right for you or the timing isn't right. God may decide to unite both of you in the future or he may not. God sees the beginning and the end. All things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are the called according to his purpose. You may question why God will allow a perfect man or woman to walk out of our life. But God knows you and is too good to withhold the best from you. He's got better for you. Trusting God also requires trusting His timing. God sent them out of your life because He has better things in store. Sometimes we hold onto things thinking that this is the best life has to offer. We have no idea what God has in store for us. For eyes hath not seen, nor ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man the things which God hath prepared for them that love him. So God is just waiting for you to trust him so he can pour out those blessings on you. God wants you to choose to follow him, and when you do, you will be guided through his plan for your life. However, choosing to follow God does not prevent bad things from happening to you. The enemy will attack you more now because you have chosen to do the right thing. God allows bad things to happen to us because trials and tribulations build our character. There is no victory in comfort. Bad things happen to Jesus as well, and he is perfect. God alone knows the plans he has for you, plans to bring you prosperity, progress, good health, inevitable relationship, and not disaster, plans to bring about the future you hope for. If you allow God to make the plans for you, he will take you through the right road that won't lead to death. When you place your life in God's hands, you can be rest assured that he is protecting us. Even when we choose to do the opposite of God's will, he is always trying to get us back on the right track. He loves you so much and doesn't want to lose you to the wrong one. When you understand that everything happened for a reason, you will be able to move on quickly and grasp what God has in store for you. It is easier to learn lessons from our experiences. For instances, that person may have left because of something you said. Now you can learn to better control your tongue. Sometimes God removes people from your life so that you can have time for some important things in your life. God knows what is best for your life, and he won't mislead you. If he removes them, then it's for your own good. When God removes someone from your life, although it may be hard to let go, it may be painful because you are attached to them. I understand, but don't fight it or chase after them. See it as blessing in disguise. You might not know what the future holds, but you know who holds the future, which is Jesus Christ. Sometimes God's plans for our good can hurt. God often removes something that will eventually kill us, just as a surgeon removes a tumor. The end is always good, but the cutting can hurt. God intentionally removes people, things, desires, and passions from our life to protect us, encourage us, and draw us closer to him. Please do not misunderstand. God is not a mean or selfish God. In fact, God is jealous. He loves each and every one of us so passionately that he is jealous for our affection. Exodus 34 verse 14 says, "Do not worship any other God, for the Lord whose name is jealous is a jealous God." He is quite simply and indefinitely in love with you so much that he clearly desires the best in every area of your life and will remove anything that gets in the way of that. This shows that God's plans are better than your own plans. God is better. He is better than your plans. His own plans are by far better than your own plans, and he is better than anything you treasure. As it is written in Proverbs 3 verse 5, "Trust him with all your heart and do not lean on your own understanding." You need to believe he truly wants great things for you. He said in Jeremiah 29 verse 11, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." You can count on God's promise and know that if it is not good, God is not done.